This is the new controller from Sony. It's the DualSense engine and it's for the PS5. And PlayStation confirmed this is the best controller they have ever made. I don't know about you guys, but when I was playing the PS1, I thought that was the best controller when I was playing Ape Escape. Now, at the back straight away, you're insulted by Sony. Perfect your gameplay. You know, like we're not pros as it is already. Ultra customizable controls. We'll look at that more in a minute, but I think what they're trying to say is it's a bit like a Lego where you can put different parts together. Multiple back buttons. What that means is the back buttons, you can change them to whatever you want them to do. DualSense wireless controller features built-in. No shit, because if that was a built-in, you'd make no sales.
Oh no!
And replaceable stick modules. You know, for those of you who eat Doritos when you're playing gameplay, you might get some stick drift, so you'll need to replace them. Now let's cut this open. All you got to do is get a knife and you just slice and dice from right here. Now, of course, the first thing you get is a user manual. Now, obviously, the box wouldn't be complete without this. Now, this is very important. When you get a chance, do read this. It tells you stuff like you shouldn't eat the controller, you shouldn't put any of the buttons in your mouth, you know, you shouldn't throw the controller at people, and then you've got a guarantee book with it as well. So these are very important documents. Now on to the main course. You get, obviously, this carry case, this nice hard shell, and it feels very, very smooth. So when you're carrying this around, just be extra careful, because this can easily slip out of your hand. Another thing I really like is the zips here. They've got the PlayStation logos on them. I think that looks really cool. So let's go ahead and just unzip this. Just do it all the way around and then just open it. And there you are. There you are. There you are presented with the bad boy. Now this controller looks like the normal PS5 controller, but it has more shine to it. And obviously when you pay £200, you want it to look that extra special. So if we just pull it out and have a look at it, it looks really amazing. I like the simplicity of it. It's just black and white and that's just very plain. It looks really nice, but one thing I've noticed is it's quite heavy. So straight away on first impression, I think this serves two purposes. The first purpose is you kick your mate's ass in any game, and the second purpose is if your mate's annoying you, just launch it at their head.
Oh, no.
I'm joking, don't do that. If you do that, you're gonna avoid the warranty. Now just having a quick look around the pad, it looks exactly the same as a PS5 pad from the front with the exception of these two buttons here. Now on the side, if you look, this is the same, it's smooth, and the back is also the same. You have the small triangle, circle, X and square design all over the back. In the middle here you have the same on the black pad here. Up here you have the two triggers which are the same as a PS5 pad with the exception of the extra here which you have the triangle, circle, X and square which is not on the normal PS5 pad. Now if you have a look at the back of the controller you have RB and LB. You have parts which go into here so we'll look at that in a short while. Up here you have a slider next to each trigger. When the slider is at the top the trigger goes all the way down. The slider is in the middle, the trigger goes halfway down, and when it's at the bottom, the trigger only goes a quarter of the way down. Now, this slider does not add tension to these triggers, but it just stops them in different positions. This is to customize your gameplay however you want it to be. Now, let's come back to the RB and LB. So, two connector types go in here. You've got this larger one and you've got the smaller one. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one in each so I can compare it when I'm holding it in my hand. They're very simple to put in. All you got to do is just push it down and that's it. It's in place. And you do the same on the other side. Make sure you get it in the right way because if you put it in the wrong way, it's not going to go in and it'll end up damaging it. So now when you're holding the pad, you obviously have your hand like this. And then this is how you access it. Now, in my opinion, I think the bigger one better because it sticks out more and it's easy to press. Whereas the smaller one, it almost feels as though you got to put your finger really against the pad. Touch it. This one here is loose, so you can just push it with your finger like this. I prefer this one, but whatever you guys prefer, it's your choice. Now down here, it says release.
Not for release.
This is to open this front bit here. Now, I had to take my gloves off for this because it's very, very hard to get your hand in there. But once you get your finger in there, you just slide it to the side and the front face just falls off like that. Now once that comes off at the front here, you've got these two customizable parts which come out and they're very easy to take out. All you got to do is just lift this here and then just slide out of their place. Let's take a closer look at one of these Joy-Cons. Now down here you have the FN button and you've got these on both sides. Now what I understand these are for is to easily change profiles. I don't know if you can change them to do anything else, but that's what I've read. And up here you have these parts. Now these can easily come off. All you gotta do is just apply a bit of pressure and pull them and then you get four extra parts to put on top, but these are not the same as what you get on here, whereas this is dinted in slightly. This is just smooth all around and it's very easy to put on. All you gotta do, again, just put it in place, push it down, and it's as simple as that. Now you might have a stick drift issue and that's why you want to replace them, but they give you extra parts with this. And when I bought this pad, I actually got extra Joy-Cons with it as well. Sony actually call them stick modules, I call them Joy-Cons. Same thing, you get my drift, but this is what I got with it for free. Now you pay in excess of £200 for a joypad, so The least you expect is a braided cable, and this is what Sony gives you. They give you the braided cable. It's a USB type A to a USB type C, and both sides are well protected, so you won't be damaging this anytime soon. This final piece that you get here, what this does is you open it from the back, you put the charging cable in there, you close it, and then you can securely lock it against the pad's USB-C charging port. Now, I personally don't use things like this, but there might be some of you out there who do use it. But one thing I do see that it is quite useful for is if you come back to the box, you just push this and it opens. So when you're laying the pad in here, put this on, this can stick out the back, and then you can have the charger like that, and that way it's safe. So if it falls, it won't do any damage. And that is it, the unboxing of the PS5 DualSense Edge pad. If you guys have purchased this, let me know what you think of it in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next one.